May 25th is a very special day in the United States. It has been commemorated since 1983 when President Ronald Reagan proclaimed it National Missing Children's Day. On May 25th, 1979, Eitan Patz, a six-year-old, disappeared from his New York City home on his way to school. At the time of his disappearance, cases of missing children rarely garnered national media attention. Eitan's father, a professional photographer, distributed photos in an effort to find his son. This resulted in a massive search. The media attention that followed focused on the problem of child abduction. As per the National Center for Missing Children and Exploited Children, every May 25th, which is the anniversary of Eitan Patz's disappearance, the nation observes Missing Children's Day. For more than three decades, the search for Eitan has continued. We never forget a child, no matter how long they have been missing. National Missing Children's Day honors this commitment to help locate and recover missing children like Eitan.
I'm delighted to have the opportunity to help launch the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children to tell you that the safety and protection of our children is a top priority on the national agenda. All Americans, and especially our youth, should have the right and the opportunity to walk our streets, to play, and to grow, and to live their lives without being at risk. But sadly, our children are at risk. Johnny Gosch, age 12, Des Moines, Iowa, vanished from his paper route in September of 1982. He's still missing. Kevin Collins, a 10-year-old lad from San Francisco, disappeared last February after basketball practice. Ann Gottlieb, 12, of Louisville, Kentucky, has been gone without a trace since last summer. And then there was Adam. America knows Adam Walsh and one of his tragic story, an innocent victim of a cruel, predatory crime. There are too many children like Adam, too many stolen each year from loved ones, too many who feel pain and suffering, too many who fall prey to exploitation and death. We don't know the exact number of victims, but it's certainly numbers in the thousands.
We are often asked what we've learned and what is the perspective of the victim. First, I can't give the perspective of the victim because the real victim isn't here. We're not the real victims. We're just the heartbroken parents left behind. The people who prey upon our women and children have counted on this society's aversion to the problem and people's tendency to turn their heads. We are all responsible for all the children.
Almost all of these cases, somebody knows something, and we need them.
That's what's so frustrating.
Absolutely. I mean,
there are people, and it's often more than one person knows something.
And we need them to trust their instincts, look at the pictures. If they see something unusual, step up and do something.
Elizabeth Smart told me this, and so did Sean Hornbeck. Sean Hornbeck said, nobody has the right to ask me why I didn't run. Right. I was 8 years old. Sure. I weighed 70 pounds. The man weighed 220 pounds and beat me and scared the hell out of me. I never believed that I could get away.
I remember walking in, and he was sitting in a chair. His head was down. And he looked up, and when he looked, I knew immediately that that was him. And that was just the most wonderful feeling that you could have. You know, and he immediately stood up We must have hugged for 30 minutes without even letting each other go. You know, and just telling him I'm so glad he's home and that I loved him and just missed him so much. But I don't think I'll ever forget that.
Elizabeth Smart was kidnapped in her house with her 9-year-old sister in the bedroom. There were a couple occasions the guy who kidnapped her did 3 days in jail for robbing a church while his crazy wife, Wanda Barzee, kept her handcuffed next to her. And when I talked to Elizabeth after her kidnapping, and I'm the guy that advises all the families, get the therapy. The National Center provides full-time free therapy. Do it when you're ready for it. But Elizabeth went, John, it sets me back. It breaks my heart. It kills me when people say I didn't run. This guy told me, I got in your house one time, didn't I? I'll go back and kill your little sister. You don't run. You're so broken down. You're terrified. And when I hear somebody else say, this kid should have run, those women should have run, I go, God, you walk in those shoes for one day, and I'll see if you ran.
What I saw there was a girl who was not the same Elizabeth that left. I just got her shoulders and I put her back because I didn't feel like there was this tremendous emotion initially from her. And I said, Elizabeth, is it you? She said, yes, Dad. And I stood there crying and crying and crying.
To know and suspect that your child's become a victim of foul play, but the not knowing is the worst.
We're hoping it'll reach the people out there and inform them that stranger abduction, child abduction of any kind is a serious problem. Maybe some kid out there that's missing will see it and come forward and make an attempt to go home.
It was you who said that hope is a verb.
Hope is a verb. You don't see parents sitting home with their feet on the couch saying, hey, I hope someday I find my child. It's a verb. It's an action word.
You get your sleeves rolled up, you got to go out there.
Absolutely. And we will never stop. We're fighting for our children. They have hopes and dreams and potential, and it's our job to find them. We can never give up, ever.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
There are about 800,000 children who are reported missing every year in this country. Within those 800,000, largest number are runaways. There are about 200,000 children a year who are abducted by other family members, including non-custodial parental abductions. And then there are about 58,000 children a year who are abducted by non-family members. Most of those very short term, in which children are taken by someone for sexual purposes or other criminal purposes, victimized and then let go. And then there are about 115 or 120 cases a year in this country that we call stereotypical kidnappings. These are the most serious, most dangerous cases in which children are abducted by strangers and are either murdered or ransomed or taken with the intent to keep or transported a great distance. I'm Ernie Allen. I'm the president of the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children.
I thought